I was hired in Germany in 1951 to work on the Snowy Mountains hydroelectric scheme as part of a group of 52 Germans. In July of that year, after clearing health security checks and paying my own fare, I arrived in Jünderbein. We were given a choice of accommodation, tents or barracks. Of course we chose the barracks. We were issued with two army blankets and a hessian bag and got told to get straw from the near horse stables to be our mattresses. Arriving at the barracks, we found they weren't actually finished. No windows or doors yet. I moved into a room with a friend, so we could use two blankets to cover the door and windows, the other two blankets to cover ourselves, and slept fully closed. We collected newspapers for extra insulation. A few weeks later, I was working on a bulldozer building the road from Island Bend to Gattaca. In the snowmelt, our machines kept getting bogged all the time. In 1956, during one of the worst winters on record in Cabalmar, we often had 2 to 3 meters of snow to clear. Once, during the heavy blizzard, we had to keep clearing the road from Sorbit Creek to Kyandra for almost 48 hours straight, without food, drink or sleep. And my dozer didn't even have a cabin. On one of my fuel stops, all I found to eat at Sorbit Creek camp was a tin of peaches. At about 5 a.m. towards Kyandra, my headlights stopped working and Blake Finch kept slipping, making it almost impossible to continue. I stopped and saw two figures walking through the blizzard. One of the men yelled, "What's the problem?" I shouted back, "I've had enough." He said, "Mate, Parker on the side." I said, "Yeah, my boss, Mr. Munro, won't be too happy about that." He then pulled off his balaclava laughing and said, "Mate, I'm Mr. Munro, and how about I showed you breakfast at the Kyandra Hotel? It was almost an hour on foot. I can tell you eggs and bacon never tasted better." There were so many times like these when I felt honored and proud to be working on the Snowy with such great bunch of blokes, Aussies and many other nationalities, all pulling together. I met my beautiful wife, Krista, up in Cabalmar in 1957 when I was driving the Torner crane, lifting the prefab houses onto their foundation. I worked on just about every road throughout the Snowy, and in later years also the construction of the Cooma Airport and Jünderbein Pumping Station. This is a photo of me and my two daughters at the opening of Cooma Airport. For 35 of my 90 years, I worked for the Snowy, and it also took my family and I to places like Thailand, Western Samoa, Indonesia and Yemen. It gave me a truly adventurous and amazing life.